हेलो फ्रेंड्स, प्रणाम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर कीपिंग वेल। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट बायोडायवर्सिटी इन द वर्ल्ड। फ्रेंड्स, वी नो दैट नाउअडेज वी आर ऑब्जर्विंग मेनी चैलेंजेस एज फार एज बायोडायवर्सिटी इज कंसर्न। सो मेनी स्पीशीज वी आर लूजिंग ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस। सो देर इज अ ग्रेट नीड टू कंजर्व बायोडायवर्सिटी। It is not a national problem, it is not a local problem. Across the globe, we are observing this challenge. So let's talk about this, friends. Biodiversity and ecological hotspots. So let's try to understand what is biodiversity. You know that in the whole world, we have many ecological systems, many ecosystems are there, and a large variety of plant species as well as animal species are there, bird species are there. So we have biodiversity in the world because same kind of climatic conditions or vegetation types we don't have. So we have variety of vegetation, variety of climatic conditions. That is why we have great biodiversity in the whole world. Okay, why? Because we have interlinkages of all life forms. That is why it is helping us in maintaining ecological balance. And as I told you just now, nowadays we are observing the problem of environmental degradation. What is environmental degradation? Contamination of important elements in our environment, air, water, forests are degrading, and we are losing these species, plant species, animal species, bird species. So all these things are there. Imbalance we are creating, which leads to imbalance in many other species. If imbalance in one species is there, then it leads to imbalance in many other species. That is why we always say, if one food chain is disturbed, then many food chains or food webs are going to be disturbed. Okay, so just now we have discussed about challenges. Why we are observing these challenges? Because we have increased rate of, very high rate of, rapid rate of consumption of natural resources. We are consuming forest at a very rapid rate and many other natural resources we are consuming at rapid rate. That is why we are observing these problems, and we are losing species and their habitation, their natural environment also we are losing. And this is a kind of cause and effect relationship. We are losing species and their habitation. Because we are losing their natural habitat, that is why we are losing more and more species on daily basis. Why? That is very, very simple to understand, my dear friends. Deforestation is going on because of urbanization, because of expansion of industries, because of expansion of agricultural areas. For so many reasons, we are clearing forest, right? And at the same time, some natural calamities are also there. Sometimes floods are there. Sometimes earthquakes are there. Sometimes cyclones are there. They are also responsible for the loss of biodiversity. And what is the result of all this? Ecological imbalance. So these are causes. Now consequences. Ecological imbalance. Just now we have discussed what is ecological imbalance. And extinction of many species. And many species are becoming endangered also. Okay, so all these are the causes and consequences of loss of biodiversity, you can say that. Now, my dear friends, we need to conserve biodiversity. We need to conserve the areas wherever we have biodiversity areas. So for this, we need to understand in the whole world, where do we have biodiversity areas, great biodiversity areas. Great biodiversity areas are named as ecological hotspots in the world. Ecological hotspots. Now, with the help of the world map, we'll try to understand the areas in the whole world where we have dense forests, where we have great biodiversity areas and ecological hotspots. So, let's see that. It's very easy to understand. We know the areas where we have high rainfall, and the high rainfall is very, very favorable for the growth of vegetation, and in dense vegetation areas we have great biodiversity areas, right? So one by one we'll try to understand. I have written few numbers here. You can see this is North America continent, this is South America continent. In between we have Central America. So western side of Central America is known as Central American Highland Forest. Central American Highland Forest. Okay, where is easy to remember its location? Central America, western side. Now on the eastern side of Central America, we have Central American Lowland Forest. Central American Lowland Forest. Okay, both are very close to each other. Then next is Western Ecuador Colombian Chocó. You can see this is your Latin America continent, and in Latin America continent this area, this northern part, northwestern part, is Western Ecuador Colombian Chocó. Western Ecuador and Colombian Chocó. Because this is Ecuador and this is Colombia, these two countries are there, that is why. And then this is extended towards south, the northwestern part of Latin America continent. This is the next one. Andes mountains are there, and this is a tropical region, so we call them tropical Andes, right? In previous classes you have discussed about the mountains, major mountain chains in the world, so Andes is one of them. So this one is tropical Andes, right? You see this one. Now next we have Atlantic Forest. Atlantic Forest in Brazil. You know, this is your Brazil, and this part of Brazil is named as Atlantic Forest in Brazil. Atlantic Forest in Brazil, right? Now the next one is in Africa continent. These all are in Americas. Okay, Central America and Latin America. Now we have Africa continent, and this part of Africa is your Guinea. Guinea country is here, and this is the upper part of Guinea, so we call it Upper Guinean Forest. Okay, it's very easy to remember. This in the northwestern part, and then we have this region. This is your Tanzania country, and forest in Tanzania is this one. This is the next one. I have written all the names in short here in abbreviations because there is a paucity of space here. So full form and expanded form I am writing on that side. This is your Eastern Arc Mountains of Tanzania. Eastern Arc Mountains of Tanzania. Right? And then we have, you know, in the southwest, southeast of Africa, we have Madagascar Island. And in the eastern part of Madagascar, we have another forest area, which is a famous biodiversity area, ecological hotspots. So this is eastern Madagascar. ओके इन अफ्रीका कॉन्टिनेंट इटसेल्फ। ईस्टर्न मेडागास्कर, ओके देन वी हैव द नेक्स्ट वन। यू सी दिस इज योर एशिया कॉन्टिनेंट, इन एशिया कॉन्टिनेंट ऑल्सो वी हैव मेनी रीजन्स विच आर फेमस एज बायोडायवर्सिटी एरियाज। यू नो दिस रीजन वेस्टर्न घाट्स, ओके वेस्टर्न घाट्स, दिस इज योर वेस्टर्न घाट्स। सो वेस्टर्न घाट्स इन इंडिया इज योर नेक्स्ट रीजन। आई हैव रिटन हियर WGI, वेस्टर्न घाट्स इन इंडिया। ओके नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन, इन द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया एंड सम पार्ट ऑफ नेपाल वी हैव द हिमालयाज, ईस्टर्न हिमालयाज। सो दिस रीजन इज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट ग्रेट बायोडायवर्सिटी एरिया, इकोलॉजिकल हॉटस्पॉट इन द वर्ल्ड, EH, ईस्टर्न हिमालयाज। राइट, ओके एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज इन श्रीलंका। यू नो इन द साउथ ऑफ इंडिया वी हैव श्रीलंका कॉन्टिनेंट, दिस इज योर श्रीलंका, दिस रीजन इज योर श्रीलंका, दिस इज सिन्हराजा फॉरेस्ट इन श्रीलंका। नेक्स्ट वन, सिन्हराजा फॉरेस्ट इन श्रीलंका। ओके फ्रेंड्स, नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज योर इंडोनेशिया। यू सी इन साउथ एशिया वी हैव दिस रीजन, दिस रीजन, राइट, दिस इज योर इंडोनेशिया कंट्री, मेनी आइलैंड्स आर देयर, सो दिस इज योर ग्रेट ecological hotspot in the South Asia. You know near equatorial areas we have high rainfall, that is why most of the hotspots, ecological hotspots are found in equatorial areas. So this is your Indonesia. Number 12, okay, and then next number 13 is your Northern Borneo. You see this island, this one, this is Northern Borneo, I have written over, and this is your 13 number. So this one is your Northern Borneo, right, this area I have marked here. Many islands are there, you know, in Southeast Asia region. So this northern part of this island is Northern Borneo. Okay, and the next one is your Philippines. This region is your Philippines, this one, right? So I've written P here, Philippines or Philippines, right? And the next one is number 15, that is also very close to this region. You see, I have marked here, you know, this is your Southeast Asia region, this is your Malaysia country, and this peninsula region of Malaysia is your this one, number 15, another important ecological hotspot in the world, peninsular Malaysia. You see, I'm writing it. And then we have one more. You all know this is your Australia. And in the northeastern part of Australia, this region, okay, this region, northeastern part of Australia, we have Queensland. Okay, and one more is also there in this Oceania region, or you can say Australia region only. This one, you know, many islands are there, and in the eastern part of Australia, you know, eastern region away from Australia, in the east of Australia, we have one more important ecological hotspot, that is Melanesia. That is Melanesia. It is also known as New Caledonia. So this one, right? So all these areas are popular as famous ecological hotspots in the world. So in today's discussion, we have understood what is biodiversity. What are the important causes of loss of causes responsible for the loss of biodiversity? What are their consequences? And then important ecological hotspots in the world with the help of world map. All these 17 areas we have discussed, we have marked, we have located there in the map. Okay, so I hope you have understood well this concept, which is very, very important in your syllabus. Okay. So God bless you all. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.